How to deal with postpartum hair loss. You have enough stress trying to adjust to life with a new baby. The last thing you need is for your hair to start coming out. And yet, postpartum hair loss is a natural and totally normal product of hormone shifts after pregnancy. However, now that you've given birth to that little bundle of joy, those hormones have shifted, and now you're shedding all the hair you would have shed while you were pregnant, all at once. Eating healthy, staying active, taking time to rest, and taking vitamins and supplements as necessary can help minimize your hair loss. At the same time, you may need to switch hair care products or even get a new haircut to help your hair look its best while you're dealing with postpartum hair loss. Within a few months, your hair will go back to looking about the same as it did before you were pregnant. But if your hair loss is bothering you, there are treatments you can try to make your hair appear fuller and healthier. Eat well. Try eating eggs for breakfast to help strengthen your hair. Eggs have plenty of protein and are rich in omega-3 fatty acids, which your body needs to grow strong, healthy hair. While you may not have time to make yourself a big breakfast every morning, you may be able to hard-boil eggs in advance so you can grab one or two in the morning to eat along with some fresh fruit, or a light salad. Include foods with protein and iron in every meal to lessen hair loss. Hair loss can be a symptom of a protein or iron deficiency. On the other hand, eating foods with significant amounts of protein and iron strengthens your hair and may help keep your postpartum hair loss to a minimum. Foods you should eat regularly include lean meats, quinoa, lentils, spinach, almonds. Caring for your hair and scalp. Massage a little peppermint oil into your scalp before shampooing. Studies have shown that peppermint oil can naturally boost hair growth. Next time you shower, mix a few drops of peppermint oil into some almond or olive oil and massage it into your scalp. Then, shampoo your hair as you normally would. Invest in a quality, gentle hairbrush to avoid breakage. If you're worried about too much of your hair snapping or getting tangled in the bristles of your old brush, it might be time for a new one. Choose a brush with softer bristles that are further apart to help prevent breakage. If you use a comb more than a brush, look for a wide tooth comb that will glide through your hair to gently detangle it without promoting shedding. Avoid arranging your hair in tight hairstyles to minimize stress on your hair. Pulling your hair into tight ponytails or cornrow braids or sewing in a weave puts additional stress on your hair and can cause it to weaken or break. If you need to pull your hair back to get it out of your face or keep it out of the way, try a loose ponytail with a soft scrunchie instead of an elastic hair tie. Add volume to your hair with mousse. Mousse is one hair product that helps lock in your hair's moisture and boosts the volume in your hair, making it appear fuller. Avoid using mousse too close to your scalp, as it can make your hair look oily or dirty. The same thing will happen if you use too much. A dollop of mousse in your palm is all you need to work through your hair. Choose a shorter, more low-maintenance hairstyle if you have long hair. Changing your hairstyle or going with a shorter can help disguise the appearance of postpartum hair loss. Shedding will also likely be less noticeable than it would be if you had longer hair. Take nutritional supplements. If you are concerned with postpartum hair loss, speak with your doctor about taking vitamin or mineral supplements to help stop hair loss and promote hair regrowth. The American Pregnancy Association recommends the following: vitamin B complex and/or biotin, B7, iron, vitamin C, vitamin E, zinc. These nutrients may already be present in your postpartum recovery plan, so be sure to talk to your doctor before taking any supplements. Reduce stress. Taking steps to reduce your stress levels has the added benefit of helping to regulate hormone imbalances. Practice different relaxation techniques like mindfulness, meditation, or breathing exercises. Make time for regular gentle or moderate exercise, which can also help reduce stress. Ask for friends and loved ones for help taking care of the baby or even household chores if you're feeling overwhelmed. Try it and share the results with us. If you like the video, give us a thumbs up. For more video how to do everything, subscribe to the channel.